diploma course selection evening for ISHMIC for 2014-15. So, what I'd like to start off with saying is a big thank you to all the people that have helped to put this together this evening, and over the next couple of weeks, all the other practices and organisation, etc., that have been put together to help all the students make the best choices. So first of all, I'd like to thank Ms. Nizam for all the work that she's done with regard to this particular evening and the course selection handbook that is currently up online so everyone can look at. And of course, there's a hard copy of it over there. I'd also like to thank all the leaders of learning that supplied lots of the information for that and are here this evening, and all the teachers, and the counsellor, the college counsellor, Miss Casey, who again has put lots and lots of work into this evening. So thank you, all those people, for that. Now, obviously, this evening is very, very important, because what will happen tonight and what happens over the next few weeks will impact the students over the next 2 years, in other words, the final 2 years of their school lives. So it's very important that the best choices are made. Now, we all face choices in our lives. Now, one of the great things about this choice is that you have people to help you, make the right choices. Now, with regard to that, that is the teachers that are here very much so tonight, but also that haven't been able to make it tonight, but are also within the school and already are always available for you to have access to. It's important to ask the experts. The teachers are the experts in this position, in this situation, so do not hesitate after the presentations have occurred to speak to the teachers about anything that you wish to you add to all the information that you gather tonight, and please make sure to speak to them outside this venue to get as much information as you can to make the right choices. Now for students, of course, there's lots of stuff for you to think about, for you to absorb, so that you end up making the right choices. There's lots of pressures, there's lots of decisions to make. There are lots of things that you might have in your head with regard to, oh, I want to do this in the future, so I must do these courses. Lots of things your parents might say. Mum and dad might be saying, I want you to do this, you should take these courses. Tonight and over the next few weeks, you must make the right choices for you. Now, with regard to doing that, again, ask the experts. But it's so important that you choose the right courses that fit with your abilities and your skills. So tonight is the beginning of that process, but I think it's very, very important for the students to remember this is about you, these are about your choices. So, without any further ado, I'll pass you on to Ms. Nizam to give you some more details about the specifics of the diploma programme. Thank you.
Good evening. Okay. It's my pleasure to welcome you this evening to the IB Diploma Programme course selection evening. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to take you through the next few weeks and what we're going to be doing to help you to make the best possible choices you can to have a great, very well-balanced 2 years of the IB diploma. So what's going to happen is this evening I'm going to be speaking for a while. We're going to have representatives from each subject group, so we'll have the leaders of learning from each subject group come and speak to you as well. So while we're speaking, I'll just ask you to hold your questions for a while, because after that we'll have about an hour of mingling and you can go to each of the sections where you can ask questions about different subjects. So I'm going to start off with what's going to happen over the next 3 weeks. So we're starting this information evening, as Mr. Roberts just said. Next week, there are going to be several opportunities for grade 10 students to talk in small groups with teachers of grade 11 and 12 subjects of the diploma, and also to students who are studying the diploma right now, so that students can get a clearer idea of what it means to take certain subjects. Then we're going to move to this part of the calendar. When we enter March, which is just really the following week, we're going to be handing grade 10 students hard copies of a course selection form, and I will be showing you a sample of that very soon. So students will receive a course selection form, they will then make some course selections, and they will need to get that approved by the teachers who teach them now, because we need to be able to make sure that students are choosing subjects that are appropriate to them, they're an appropriate challenge, and they are the sort of subject choice combinations that really are what students need to do the very, very best. A week later, on Friday the 14th of March, that's a deadline by which the course selection forms need to be returned. So they will be returned back to homeroom teachers and then back to me, and then I can take a look at that and we can help students to make that into a book. By that time, we'll know what the students are doing. We can take a look at that then. So that's the deadline. So in the next few weeks, there are many opportunities for students to make the right decision. Okay, now a quick thing about the IB Diploma Program. The IB Diploma Program is around the world, so you can see in nearly 140 countries. Actually, right over there in the diagrams, all you can see are the actual IB International Baccalaureate offices. That's what's actually there on the diagrams. But what you can also see are numbers of schools that have the IB Diploma Program. And Asia Pacific is what we belong to. And you can see that that's 386 programs at the moment, or 386 schools. That is the fastest growing region for the IB diploma. But far beyond, the largest area are the Americas. So North America and South America, there are many, many, many schools that run the IB diploma program. So it is a program that is very well known and recognized by universities. And why do universities love it? Well, the biggest thing, at the end of the day, what are students going to end up with? They're going to end up with some grades that universities are going to look at. They're going to have learned a lot over a period of 2 years. And if I just explain a little bit about this, external assessments, right? So students study six subjects and some extra things over a period of 2 years, and then they have some exams. Now, these examinations are set by the IB, and they are marked by examiners of the IB to very rigorous academic standards. There are also other assessments that are sent straight to the IB and marked by the IB as well. There are also some other assessments which are internal assessments. So what they tend to be are assessments that run over a longer period of time. And they're assessed in the school, and then samples are sent to the IB for moderation. Another very important thing that I should say about the assessment. So what is assessment for? Sure, at the end of 2 years, there are final assessments and you end up with a score which universities get to see. But along the way, what really makes the IB program really, this is the underlying philosophy with the IB program, for all three IB programs, starting from grade three all the way up to the point when students are going off to university. This is the central part of philosophy, that we're teaching students that they're learning to be learners. It's all about independent learning, and to support that, what we do is we take students' assessments on an ongoing basis throughout the school year. And the idea is that when you have unit tests, or when you have specially designed assessments which are there to help students gain the skills they need, as we go along that process, we take a look at the assessments, we see how students are doing, and that guides the teaching and the planning that takes place after that. And this also is how we feed back to students, so students can get the skills to then take responsibility for their own learning. And this is very much part of the way that assessments work in the IB diploma. Another reason why universities love the IB diploma. The way that the assessments are set up and the way that the IB diploma works, it's there to really support independent learning and inquiry. It isn't a matter of just learning a lot of facts and then putting it out on a paper in an exam. The way that the investigations are run for all the different subject areas and the way that the assessments are set up, they force students to really think beyond just the textbook. It really is about experiential learning and taking ideas and transferring them into new situations. So, as you can see, these are some of the things that have been said by some universities. Now, there is quite a lot of research to support the idea that students who have undergone the IB diploma program, because of this, the nature of the assessments, the nature of the learning that takes place, and the overall structure of the program, it really stretches the cognitive abilities of these students. The academic habits that students are put in a position which they have to develop, the time management skills, the self-management skills, the way that you balance all the different tasks that you have to carry out, it really puts students in a great position when they go to university. At the end of this presentation, I'll show you a link where you can see some research about this. Okay, so now this is, I'll take you through the program and what students actually learn over these 2 years. So this is the IB diploma program diagram. Now, I understand that when you look at blue with white writing on it, you can't read everything there, but what I have prepared for you as well is another slide where you can see a little bit more in detail. But what I'd just like to point out to you here is that in this circle here, you have six subject groups. Now, these six subject groups are things which the students are going to be very familiar with when they make their subject choices. There are six subject groups, and from each of these groups, they choose a subject. That's the general structure. So three of those subjects will be chosen at a higher level, which is 240 hours in the 2 years of lessons. And then they choose three standard level subjects, which is 160 hours over the period of 2 years. Now, the difference isn't just to do with the number of hours of lessons that students have. It's a bit more than that. It depends on the subject. So for some subjects, it means that there is more content and more complexity to some of the concepts. In other subjects,